His works take place in His name. John chapter 14, verses 13 and 14. And whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. As Jesus gave that amazing statement in John 14, 12, that those who believe in Him, the works He did, they will also do, and greater works because He went to the Father. We are going to examine everything He said around that statement, continuing on through the 14th chapter, in fact, even leading to the 15th chapter. What did He say around that statement? Because that will give us insight onto how we're going to do that. And immediately after Jesus made that statement in John 14, 12, the first things He mentions in verses 13 and 14 is about us making use of His name. He said, right after verse 12, He said, whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. So, His works take place in His name. Using His name is key then to for us as believers in doing His works in His name. He said, whatever you ask in my name. We need to understand what it means to use the name of Jesus. Now, typically in a Christian church setting, we use the name of Jesus, and very often it's used just as a routine thing. You know, so we all say in Jesus' name, so everybody knows when to say amen or when to close up the prayer and things like that. It's just something of a traditional thing. Oh, but we don't understand the significance, the power behind us using His name. And so if we are going to see His miraculous works take place through our lives, through our hands, the sick healed, the devils cast out, demons cast out, and miracles taking place, we must understand the potential, the power, the authority that's in the name of Jesus. And we must understand what it means when we use that name. When we say in the name of Jesus, it means we are drawing our authority from the authority of that name. We are exercising what we will call as delegated authority, the power of attorney. The power of attorney or the authority that we are walking in is only as powerful as the name that's behind it. So when we say in Jesus' name, we are saying in the name that is above every other name, in the name of the one who is exalted to the Father's right hand, in the name of the one who died on the cross, who rose up from the dead, who has paid for all our sins, who's defeated Satan, in His name. And when we say in the name of Jesus, it means we are standing here on His behalf as His representative to do what He would do if He were here Himself. That's what it means when we say in His name. We are coming in the full power and authority of that name, and we are coming as His representative. We are standing in His place to do exactly what He would do if He were here. So, miracles, His works take place in His name. We must understand the significance of using that name, of asking in His name, of demanding that something be done in His name. When we get an understanding, a revelation of that, we will begin to see His works take place through our lives. Remember, His works take place in His name. Understand the significance of using His name. Let's pray. Lord, we ask that You'll help us understand what it means when we say in the name of Jesus. Oh God, open our hearts to understand the power that's in that name and the authority we are exercising when we say in Jesus' name. Let mighty things take place through our lives in that name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.